آله وصحبه وسلم. البداية أودي أهنيكم شهر رمضان، نسأل الله يتقبل منا ومنكم هذا الشهر ويعيننا على صيامه وقيامه، ونسأل الله أن يكشف هذه الأمة عن هذه الغمة عن الأمة. وإن شاء الله today we'll discuss the glaucomatous optic disc. إن شاء الله. What's glaucoma? We need to define glaucoma at the beginning, عشان it will be easy for us to understand the lecture. Glaucoma is a chronic progressive disease, as we know, and it's irreversible optic neuropathy, and it's typically affect optic nerve head changes. And there will be a corresponding visual field defect, plus minus rise in the intraocular pressure. And there will be rise in the IOP is the only modifiable risk factor for glaucoma. وهذه النقطة is very important to the patient. If you define glaucoma to the patient, if you tell him this is it's an neuropathy, and I will operate to reduce intraocular pressure. Usually they will ask why you reduce the intraocular pressure. So the answer here is that this is the only modifiable risk factor for glaucoma. And this finding we need to practice daily. Finding that we will mention inshallah in this lecture, we need to, otherwise we'll forget. لذلك يقول knowledge is of least significant unless bit in practice. The optic nerve, as we know, it's almost around 5 centimeters, 50 millimeter long. It's a cylinder shape, and it's divided into four parts: intraocular and intraorbital, intracanalicular, and the fourth pass is the intracranials. Today, mainly we'll discuss intraocular, and it's the length is only 1 millimeter. So you see this 1 millimeter, we spent the whole lecture to discuss only this 1 millimeter long. The optic nerve, usually we divide it to four parts. اللي هي النير فايبر لاير وبري لامينر لاير ولامينر لاير وريترو لامينر لاير. هذا is very important, ال classification هذا ولا distributions for the mechanism of glaucoma. As we know, glaucoma either mechanical or ischemic, and it's important we to know at least the blood supply of the optic nerve. As we know, nerve fiber layer it will be supplied by the central retinal artery, and preliminary will be supplied by posterior ciliary artery, circle of Zinn, walamina cleproza it will supply also by the posterior ciliary artery, and the retrolaminar mainly by the central retinal artery. So central retinal artery and posterior ciliary artery, and the clinical relevance of ocular blood flow, the short posterior ciliary artery, it's an end arteries, and it's more liable to ischemia and emboli. As we know, the optical rim or neuroretinal rim is consist of ganglion cell action and glial tissue and blood vessels, and also it contain extracellular matrix. So this is four component for the neuroretinal rim. If we take a cross section, lamina cribrosa, you will see a pore in the lamina cribrosa. If you concentrate, you look to the superior part, this superior part, and and also the inferior parts, you see the pores is larger than the central one. Okay. And this is why we get more damage at the superior and temporal, because the pore is large and there will be less glial tissue and less extracellular matrix in this area. So the superior part and the inferior part, it's more liable to damage. Okay. And this is also the surgical slide. You see the on the left side, the optic nerve look normal, and in the glaucomatous and gross side, you see there will be a damage in the superior pole and the inferior pole of the nerve. Okay. So the optic nerve head cupping is the unifying feature of all forms of glaucoma, while the other insult to the optic nerve result in ganglion cell damage and pallor, only glaucoma lead to excavation or cupping. Rarely, arteric anterior ischemic optic neuropathy can lead to cupping. Also, change in the optic nerve generally precedes visual field loss. And this is why we try to detect the patient on this stage, the stage that we call pre-metric stage. If we detect the patient and he start to have visual field change, that means he lost or almost 25% of the optic nerve to be shown in the visual fields. And a significant amount of nerve fiber layer and optic nerve damage can occur before the visual field showing zoomations, visual field defects. So the optic nerve head examination is critical in the care of glaucoma patient and glaucoma suspect. What's normal optic nerve? Usually the cup disc ratio is 0.1 to 0.4. Some individual have no visible cup, especially in a small disc, and we'll discuss this one later. Around 5% of the normal eye have cup disc ratio of larger than 0.6. It's important to know this. And the shape of the disc is slightly oval, and usually it's 1.5 to 2.2 millimeter diameter. And usually it's symmetrical, and it's pink in color, and usually the cup is central. And if we see the distribution of the ganglion cell axon in the optic nerve, it's depend on the location of ganglion cell. The peripheral ganglion cell, it will be present at the periphery of the optic nerve, and the central or the paracentral ganglion cell, it will be present at the center and paracenter of the neural rim. And this is also important on clinical implication for this, because the peripheral usually go to the periphery optic nerve and it's more liable to damage. So the arcuate fiber usually start from the periphery, usually most liable to, most sensitive to damage. And the macular fiber, it's most resistance to the damage. Doctora, انتو معي؟ الصوت واضح ولا كل؟
يعطيك العافية.
واضح دكتور.
الله يعطيكم العافية. The evaluation of the optic disc is the most important part of the examination. وهذه الستدي اللي we know this is the most important study اللي هي ocular hypertension study. 55% of the patient diagnosed glaucoma according to the disc finding. and only 10% diagnosed by the visual field changes, and combination around 35. So 55 depend on the disc finding. طيب احنا usually changes we classify the to three parts اللي هو الريم part اللي هو papillary changes وvascular changes وبري papillary changes. We'll discuss one by one. Okay, the papillary change will study the size of the optic nerve, shape, and neuroretinal rim, اللي هو الكابينج والكالر and asymmetry of the optic disc, also progression. Size is very important. Size of the optic disc can be small, average, and can be large. And some they, if it's large, more than 2.2, they call it mega disc. Okay, but this is very rare we see. So it's either it's small, average, and large. Why we should know size? Because small disc will size have small cup, as we know, and large cup will have large disc will have large cup. So patient with small disc, we can miss glaucoma on a small disc, and we can misdiagnose glaucoma in a large disc. Okay. طيب, how can we measure an optic disc? We can use a direct ophthalmoscope. We put it in 5 degrees, and we shine the light around the optic disc, and the diameter of the light, it will be 1.5. So if it's 1.5 small, it's a very disc. If it's smaller than this, so compare it with the light reflect, the light like this photo here. We see this light in, at the, around the disc. Or usually you can use the 90, the condensation lens, but you need to correct the value. So if you use 60, just read the caliber. If you use 90, just multiply the finding by 1.3. Okay. الأوبتيك ديسك الأفريج معلش أعتذر منكم, أنا حقيقة خارج البيت وفي مكان كذا شوي عام في الفندق, فحيكون في أصوات بجنبي. الأفريج is 1.4, and if it's large it will be more than 1.6, and as we mentioned, if it's more than 2.2 تقريبا we call it mega disc, and if it's small it's less than 1.2. في الexamination, especially in a comfy area, there will be no fundus camera, it's better to document the finding in the files. Okay, all the findings, because it's very helpful in the future. Okay, the size, the shape, the sloping, the blood vessels, the finding. Try to draw the disc finding, especially first visit. And as we mentioned usually in clinic, طبعاً, when to examine the disc, the very common question, and when to do IOP and when to do visual fields. فعادةً أنا told the resident, you know, for a stable patient, you need to see to measure the IOP every 3 months, and you need to do the visual feed every 6 months, and you need to evaluate the optic nerve every 12 months. This is for a stable patient. Okay, and if patient is uncontrolled glaucoma, the assessment will be completely different. Then we move to the shape of the capping on disc. Disc usually it's vertically elongated, the disc. بينما الكب it's horizontally elongated, and it can be round, it can be vertically elongated, the capping, or it can be irregular. Okay. You see, this is round and this is oval. And also one of the most important signs is the fibrillation of isentrolad. We know this. So the inferior, superior, nasal, and temporal. And this is very important because sometimes we mention the patient having 0.5 cup and the other is 0.5. But if it's like this photo, like this one, you see in your right side, it's 0.5. And your right and your left side, it's 0.5. But in the right side, the inferior rim is already gone. So not only the size, cup disc series, you mention also the rim. The rim is very important because even if it's 0.5, but it's the inferior rim, it's already gone. This is highly suspicious of glaucoma. And this is one of the most sensitive parts. If you see one of the rim already cupped out. Okay. And as we mentioned, one of the most important also sign is the progression with time, 0.6, 0.7, and this is mean that's in uncontrolled glaucoma. Asymmetry of the cup. A nerve should be symmetrical like our hands and feet. Asymmetry of 0.2 occur on less than 1% of the normal individual. Look for cause of unilateral glaucoma. Okay. Look for asymmetry of the nerve size. نرجع للoptic nerve, size of the optic nerve. So when you compare the cup, compare also the disc in the right. Maybe the disc is small in one eye and the other eye, especially if they can, a patient and anisometropy, high myope in one eye and emmetrope in the other eye. So if you compare the emmetrope, it will be small disc, and the myope and the other eye, the disc is very large. So when you compare the cup, compare the disc. It can be different from one eye to the other. Okay. And one of the signs also, it's visible lamina cribrosa, pores of lamina cribrosa. On advanced glaucoma, you'll see you call it laminar dot sign. Okay. It's clear in this picture. As we know, some cases they have reversal of cupping, especially on pediatric, and we see it frequently. And we operate on a congenital glaucoma, you find it 0.8, and then you see him after 2 weeks post-op, you see it almost 0.2. Okay, so this is reversal of the cupping. There is three patterns of glaucoma cupping. They call it eccentric unipolar cupping, only atrophy on one pole, or bipolar atrophy, and usually it's associated with bipolar, the superior and inferior. There will be a notch in superior and inferior, and unipolar or one notch, usually inferior. So it can be unipolar or bipolar. One of the signs, scissorization. Scissorization, the sloping of the rim. Okay, that you'll have to observe cupping and measurement, but patient will have sloping of the rim. This is very important to document this one in the on the follow-up chart and to draw the site, so it will help you in the follow-up in the future. This is the different cup. It can be sloping, it can be central. And on advanced glaucoma, you will see the pin put cupping. See the blood vessel will disappear, suddenly disappear. And it's like pin put. Okay. Number four, the color of the rim. That's very important. Usually it's pink. And if it's pale, usually it's, as we know, it's neuropathy. So usually we, if we see patient, we refer them to the neuroophthalmology. So if the glaucoma test objects neuropathy, the cupping is more than bulb. And in neuropathy, the pallor is more than cupping. As we mentioned, asymmetry, if it's more than 0.2, it's significant. Okay. And we'll move to the vascular changes of the on the disc. كيف الصوت انتو معي ولا
ممكن الله تكافي واضح
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 طيب احنا قربنا ان شاء الله ما مطولين اللي هو ال as we mentioned the vascular findings اللي هو nasalization as we know pressure to push the blood vessels toward the toward the nasal part of the optic nerve, so this is a nasalization. And also, not only the nasalization of the vessels, we see also nasalization of the retinal vessel trunk. So trunk itself, you see it at the center, and it's moved toward the nasal. Not only the branch, the trunk itself, it's moved to the nasal part of the optic nerve. Also, the other sign is bionating or kinking of the blood vessels. You see the blood vessels suddenly kinked. And kinking of the vessel, it's very helpful to, especially for the high mob, well, the pale disc, is to define the cup disc ratio. So if you see kinking of the blood vessel, that means this is the edge of the cupping. Okay. And if you can see it here, blood vessel crossing the rim disappear into the deep cup, so they disappear. So and the other sign is bearing of the circumlinear vessels. The vessels that lying in the cup, and because of fast progression of the glaucoma. The blood vessel stay in place and the rim, it will cupped out. So there will be a distance between the rim and the blood vessels. So if you have serial of photos, you will see that there will be a gap between the blood vessel with time, between the blood vessels and the rim. So this is bearing of the blood vessels. Here maybe it's more clear. Also, the other sign is collaterals. As we know, in the advanced very advanced glaucoma, we can see collateral at the disc margin. So, but don't miss it with the NVD, because as we know, in the advanced glaucoma has been uncontrolled glaucoma, they are more liable to develop a vascular occlusion, center retinal vein occlusion or branch retinal vein occlusion, and usually they get disc collaterals. So don't miss collaterals with NVDs. Then we will move to the peripapillary changes. It will include the nerve fiber layer defect and disc hemorrhage and peripapillary pigmentation. This is the arcuate of the nerve fiber layer, as we discussed in the beginning. And we should look for wedge shape focal retinal nerve fiber layer defect, as you see it in your left side. defined by Darus, and you need sometimes you need to look for it, otherwise you'll miss it, and you need to dilate the patient to look for. Also, it's helpful to use the red free and also to take disc photo with the stereopsis. So if you re-evaluate the disc photo, it can help you on localizing the nerve fiber layer defect. Okay, especially for glaucoma suspect patient, especially for normal tension or low tension glaucoma. That's very helpful to start patient in medication. How it can help you on starting medications. Glaucoma, you need to be sure about the diagnosis to give the medication, because you will give medication for life, like the oral for diabetes, oral medications. So you need to be sure about the diagnosis, because you're not give it for 1 week or 2 week like antibiotic. You will give it for life. Yeah, patient who develops side effect, systemic side effects, local side effects, redness, allergy, and try to be sure about the diagnosis before starting the medication. And if you have nerve fiber layer defect, usually it will be followed by a notch at the same site, and usually it's in the inferior. So if you keep following the patient, you will see with time that at the site of defect there will be a notch in the future. Disc hemorrhage, it will be slip enter at the disc margin. It's an early sign of glaucoma. And it's common in normal tension glaucoma and also it's the most common site is the inferior quadrant, and as we mentioned, at the focal nerve fiber defect there would be a notch. And this study shows the risk of developing primary open glaucoma is 6 times greater on ocular hypertension eye with disc hemorrhage. So disc hemorrhage, it can be missed, especially if it's small and if it's near to the blood vessels. So try to also the disc photo is also very helpful. Okay. Then we move to the last thing, the peribabillary changes. As we move from the center, number one, little cupping, rim, then we'll move to the, we call it scalar ring, number three, then the beta zone and the alpha zone. Okay. We should differentiate between number three and number four, because scalar rim, sometimes you missed with the, beta zone. Usually it's a 5-layer. And there are 2 forms of periolary crescent, as we mentioned. Beta zone, it's a white area where the RPE doesn't reach to the optic nerve head. Okay. And the alpha, it's the opposite. There will be a darkening because of thickened RPE. So beta zone, there will be no RPE. And in the alpha zone, there will be a thickened RPE changes. The beta zone is more common in glaucoma, but represent in 25% of the normal populations. It's very important to around 25 in a normal population. But if you see it in a glaucoma suspect, okay, you need to observe, because with time it will progress in size. Okay, for a normal patient will be the same size, it will not increase. An area of beta atrophy is associated with glaucoma. In glaucoma, the beta area can enlarge, as we mentioned. Also, some patients, especially myopes, they have a gray crescent at the periphery. In summary, change is on the nerve, neural lateral rim, signs of optic nerve damage, number one change in the neural lateral rim. Also, development of notch, shifting of the blood vessels, disc hemorrhage, especially the recurrent one, and progressive change in the changes in retinal nerve fiber layer, enlargement of the beta zone, and development of the local neural retinal rim pallor. So this is some of the signs that you need to look for on assessment of the glaucoma patient. Almost we are done here. Some difficulty with patient with small disc, small pupil, it's difficult to evaluate the disc. So you need to dilate, and as we know, dilation, we should do gonioscopy to rule out angle closure before dilating the patient, especially if it's first time. Also, if the patient have optic disc drosin or optic disc bit, or if you have tilted disc, this is also one of the difficulties that we face, and also on high myopia disc, it's very difficult to evaluate this type of patients. Okay. If you have dense cataracts, you cannot evaluate the disc. Look to the disc in the other eye. So, try to evaluate it. This can give you a mirror give you at least hint about the optic nerve stasis in the other eye. Okay. A lot to find, but I think this is enough for today, and we can discuss the rest in the future, inshallah. La yatikum al afiya.
Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum.
يعطيك العافية دكتور سعد. معك عبد الله الغامدي. عندي سؤالين طال عمرك. السؤال الأول بخصوص الريفرس كابينج in children, as what we all know that retinal nerve fiber layers they don't regenerate. What is the pathophysiology behind reverse cupping, especially in kids? هذا السؤال الأول. السؤال الثاني طال عمرك.
شوف هو طبعاً. في اختلاف في الموضوع لكنه طبعاً البريشر تبوش ذا اكسون تو ذا بريفري اوكي سو تو ريكريز اديما عشان كذا اف يو ريفيرس البريشر بعضهم دي ثينك ذس از اونلي اديما تصف ذا اوبتيك نيرف لكنه ذس از ذا اونلي في البيدياتريك انك يو ريليز ذا بريشر اند it was pushed in the periphery. It come back to the normal, normal site. السؤال الثاني عبد الله.
يعطيك العافية. السؤال الثاني طال عمرك is in unilateral high myope patients with excavated disc and very difficult to to pick up the exact cup disc ratio. You will wait for visual field changes to start the treatment if you are suspecting glaucoma, or you will just observe the disc. What you will do?
أنا قلت لك هذه واحدة من the difficult patient to evaluate. Usually, take the history is very important. Very patient, especially they come very high myopes. تمام. If patient start to notice defect in visual fields, تمام. And also, if you compare طبعا في بعض الحالات بالجلوكوما not only them you cannot diagnose glaucoma from first visit زي اللي شاف معانا الكونجنتال جلوكوما sometimes we admit patient 3-4 times because I'm not sure about the diagnosis okay so if you are in doubt okay just keep following the patient every 3 months okay and with time it will show you the findings okay if it's progressed or stable okay so we depend on the history it's very important we depend on the visual field and OCT changes and the disc photo and our assessment so we take a lot of things to reach to the diagnosis and with time it will show the patient will be stable or he is progressing okay This is you cannot diagnose from first time.
الله يعطيك العافية دكتور سعد شكرا لك.
الله يحييك عبد الله. فيها other question ولا other comment أنا.
دكتور في سؤال هنا الدكتور ياسر الصالح any role of OCT to evaluate disc in high myopic patients
as we mentioned يعني كلها we take it الفيجوال فيد والOCT والديسك فايندينج والهيستوري في especially في الهاي مايوبس it's all important okay and especially the OCT okay sometimes we follow the cup only in high myope from the OCT okay with time if it's changing the OCT that means he's progressing okay so in high myopes it's very important to do visual feed yes we take it in consideration especially in high myopes
OCT angio doctor any role of OCT angio to evaluate disc in high myopic patients
والله don't have idea about the OCT angio on high myopes تفضل دكتورة
طيب دكتور حاتم نجيمي
طيب لو تفتحي لو انميوت هذا وخليه يتكلم عادي
طيب دكتور حاتم ask your question
الو السلام عليكم
السلام ورحمه الله
العافيه دكتور
الله يحييك
بسدك بس دكتور يعني how to comment on يعني optic nerve regarding all these features you talked about يعني in a proper way
how to
comment على صوره optic nerve يعني مثلا لو جاتنا في اختبار وكذا how to comment on all these features
طبعا احنا ذكرنا يعني most of the feature احنا كم حوالي almost 25 findings تمام هو حسب التايم اللي موجود عندك فانت يحتاج to be systemic في الاسسمنت سواء في الاكزام او في الكلينيك طبعا انا يمكن ليش تقل معي يعرف الموضوع هذا انا we need to be systemic يعني مثلا بالاكزامينيشن from the ليد كونج كورنيا انتيري تشامبر وهكذا حتى تصل للاوبتيك ديسك الاوبتيك ديسك كذلك تمام عشان اف يو ار سيتي يو نوت مس اني ثينج يعني ايذر تو ستارت فروم ذا بريفري اور فروم ذا ريم اور فروم ذا كاب اوكي ف يو كان اور ستارت اوبوزيت يو ستارت تو ذا كاب اند يو ستارت تو كومنت اون ذا كاب اللي زي ما قلنا الشيب الدامي الكونتور النوتش كذلك اللي هي لمنا دوتس وبعدين يو موف تو ذا بلاد فيزلز وبعدين يو موف تو ذا ريم وبعدين تو ذا بري بابيلري تشينجز وبعدين اوبتيك نيرف سوري ذا نيرف فايبر لير وبعدين يو كومنت اون ذا اذر اي اوكي سو تراي تو بي سيستميك اوكي حتى الاكزامينر اف يو ار يعني اذا حس انك يور انسر سيستم از يعني تلبي ألوت
الله يعطيك العافية
الله يحييك any question ولا comment؟
السلام عليكم. يعطيك العافية دكتور سعد.
الله يحييك.
معك خالد ديم.
الله يحييك دكتور خالد.
بالنسبة ل one eyed patient، هل في special consideration in the follow up for one eyed patient glaucomatous patient؟
طبعا هو في ال one eyed patient هذا يعني هذا يعامل في IB تمام. كنا حتى بالكيكاش وكان في رول انك اي وان ايت بيشنت يو شود سي هيم ريجارد لس من الكومبلين حقه كويس. فهذا اهم حاجه. ففي اذا جاك وان ايت بيشنت يو نيد تو انا جو ان ديتيل وذ هيم. لكن هي سواء وان ايت ولا اللي هو هذا يو نيد تو از وي منشن سيستميك عشان تو ريتش تو ذا دياجنوز سبيشلي بالجلوكوما. اوكي لكن ما اذكر في شيء يعني تو بي سبيسيفيك تو وان ايت بيشنت. هو ينقصه انك احيانا ما عندك اذر اي تو كومبير يعني سبيشلي اذا كان عنده الاذر اي لوست كومبليتلي. ولكنه الاذر اي لوست فروم ذا جلوكوما اتس فيري هيلبفول تو نو ذا تايب اوف ديجنوز وتو بي فيري اجريسيف في الميديكيشنز تمام والتريتمنت بيكوز في لوست اذر اي معناته انه هي فاستلي بروجريسنج جلوكوما. ف الدياجنوزز والتايب اوف جلوكوما اند اذر اي اتس فيري هيلبفول ان ذا تو تريت ذا سينج اي. الله يعطيك العافية. طيب إذا كان ما في كومنت ولا سؤال يمكن نتوقف هنا. وش رأيك دكتورة؟
الله يعطيك العافية دكتور، شكرا لك ما قصرت.
الله يحفظك.
الله it will be uploaded on BSMMC YouTube channel today.
الله يعطيك العافية. وأنا شاكر لكم وحضوركم وإنصاتكم وأتمنى قدمنا شيء يفيدكم. نسأل الله يوفقكم ونراكم زملاء قريب إن شاء الله. الله يوفقكم.